Yay, it's time for another episode of Falling Asleep with Mark. I hope that that I am currently recording and not talking to myself blankly in front of the camera. Hi, I'm Mark, and this is Falling Asleep with Mark, the best YouTube show out there for helping you get to sleep through soothing videos where I talk with my voice in my soothing, relaxing voice, which has excellent qualities to help you get to sleep. And we cover a lot of really important territory on the show, like window blinds and popcorn ceiling, and a lot of important interviews with dignitaries from all around the world. I am excited for this episode, which is really big, 'cause I recently moistened my hair and trimmed my facial hair before recording. So the theme of today's show is watching my moistened hair dry, and whoever can tell the exact time when all of the moisture is dried out of my hair will win a prize, which may consist of a jar of jelly beans. And if you guess how many jelly beans are in the jar, you win the jar. So put notes in the comments about how long it is taking my hair to dry, and you may win a prize. And subscribe to the show, 'cause that's the only way you are eligible. That's the only way you are eligible to win the jelly bean jar if you guess how long it takes my hair to dry accurately. And I will be measuring the results scientifically to avoid any possibility of inaccuracy or cheating in the forums. So go do that after the show, and remember to pay attention to the precise moment when my hair dries. Also, just kidding, there is an even better theme to today's show, which I know you're going to love, because this topic is the topic that puts absolutely everyone to sleep except weird people who have this as an occupation. Finance. Finance and money and banking and Excel spreadsheets is an excellent way to get to sleep. Whenever I can't sleep, all I do is watch Excel tutorials. Watching all of the rows and numbers and money come up on my screen is an excellent way to soothe yourself, because it's so boring that you have no other option but for your mind and body to shut down and fall asleep. So stay tuned for this exciting video, and I have all kinds of fun planned for you today, like counting money, watching Excel videos, and seeing some of my favorite Vimeo Creative Commons videos all about money and finance and high-powered business and dollar bills and numbers everywhere. And calculators, we're going to review some calculators on a future episode. And they all have a variety of different buttons and different textures on the buttons. And some calculators can do very big calculations, and then others cannot calculate more than in the millions or trillions. So it's important to get a calculator for your needs when you need to calculate numbers to help you get to sleep. So let's start the show by playing a soundtrack in the background and maybe even an exciting illustrated cartoon of me dancing as the words falling asleep with Mark move across the screen, and there are birds flying all around, and the ocean waves and palm trees. I want to live in the desert someday, 'cause the desert has not much moisture, and I can dry my hair quickly. Also, the desert has special animals like rabbits and scorpions and flies. Sometimes you even see an elk or a buffalo that got lost and is roaming through the desert and the Grand Canyon. So let's do a future episode all about the desert. I have a lot of other good episodes I'm planning soon. To give you a sneak peek, I'm planning an episode all about waterfalls, dinosaurs, and special features like birthdays and holidays like 4th of July and Memorial Day. Memorial Day is an important day to help you remember the past of America. And if you're not American and you want me to feature your country's holiday, put a note in the comments and then I will research your country's holiday, or just pretend to research it and then just improvise and totally butcher your holiday by trying to think what it is, but I don't know. So let's go ahead now and drink some tea, 'cause I'm just gonna hydrate myself for a little bit. Oh, I should do an episode where I show you my filming studio. I'll call it a studio. I just tape all kinds of tarps and lights in my living room or bedroom, and the screen behind me taped to the wall so that I can deliver you high quality videos several days of the week, including on holidays and weekends, 24/7. Bankers typically work from 9 to 5, and the theme of today's show is finance, banking, money, Excel, numbers, calculation, calculators. You get the picture. So I'm gonna try to put all finance into this episode. We're gonna count a lot of things. Let's start with this. This is a coffee mug. There is one coffee mug and one spoon in the coffee mug. I have two eyes, one, two, and one nose, one. And let's count all of the strands of my hair. And don't forget to pay attention to if it's dry yet. Not yet. Also, let me know your favorite hairstyle of mine, and I will consider wearing my hair in that fashion more often. Also, today's show is unofficially brought to you by Fiji water from the islands of Fiji, natural artesian water, 1.5 liter, 1.58 quarts. That's refreshing. Fiji water, natural electrolytes. There's electrolyte enhanced water, and there's the smarter choice in quotation marks, Fiji water. Not only does Fiji have significantly more electrolytes than other brands, ours are naturally occurring. How? As tropical rain slowly filters through volcanic rock, it gathers the electrolytes and minerals that give Fiji water its signature soft, smooth mouthfeel. How smart is that? Earth's finest water, bottled at source Yakara Viti Levu, Fiji Islands, bottled by Natural Waters of Viti Limited, comma, 1 Nasayani Road, Yakara, Fiji. Product of Fiji. For water quality and information, 1-877-426-3454, fijiwater.com. CACRVHI-ME-NY-CT 5 cent OR 10 cent. Please recycle typical analysis for taste. Silica, calcium, magnesium, pH, bicarbonates, total dissolved solids. So thank you for Fiji Water for making delicious artesian smooth mouthfeel water filtered through volcanic rock with electrolytes and minerals to give us the delicious mouthfeel of artesian water from Yakara, Fiji Islands.com. So let's go ahead and start the video. Now we are going to play a very short video in order to motivate ourselves to begin counting our own money. This video is called Counting Money, and it is from ISM Elementary School. They upload a lot of educational videos that I like to watch to learn new skills as a person. So we're going to watch them count all of the money, and we can follow along as we learn about money. So let's start the video. You can see how the kid is pointing out the quarters and the dimes, and the quarters and the pennies, and is showing us how to calculate them from the big cents down to the smaller cents. This is very complex math, so we need to use a lot of brain power to calculate all of the numbers, which will make us tired and help us get to sleep.
Hi, I'm Dylan, and I'm gonna teach you how to count by quarters, nickels, dimes, and pennies. Here's quarters, here's nickel, here's dime, and here's pennies. So I'm gonna start with nickels, and then dimes. I mean, first I'm gonna start with quarters, dimes, and then nickels, and then pennies. First you start with the biggest value, and then the next, and then the next, and then the lowest. So I'm gonna start by the quarters. 25, 50, 60, 70, 75, 76, and 77. That's how many coins we have, and now I'm going to write it down here in these boxes. There, now I am done. Bye!
That was an excellent video. I was really impressed by all of the counting that was involved, which was very soothing. And with each number that was counted, I felt myself getting even a little bit more sleepy. And I hope you are thinking the same thing. Wow, I am really sleepy now because all of the numbers make me zone out and shut down as a human being. The show is also brought to you unofficially by Harvest Club. Mother Nature would be proud. Carrots, great for snacks, salads, party trays, stir fries, soups, and casseroles. It has 110% daily value vitamin A per serving and a good source of vitamin C. You can pick up the Harvest Club carrots at your local grocery store and can enjoy chewing on the carrots and feeding them to horses. Okay, next I have a surprise for you. You've seen this from a previous episode and are going to be really excited to see what I'm about to bring next, which is relevant to today's show, but also relevant to a previous show. Ta-da, it is the duck from one of my hit episodes, Aquatic Birds, which you can access below in the descriptions. The Aquatic Birds episode covers a lot of territory, including multiple birds, like mallard ducks, like my friend here, and other topics. I have all of my coins in the duck, which we are about to count. So let's go count coins together, and slowly, one by one, we're going to count numbers and to get to sleep. Okay. One quarter, two quarters, three quarters, four quarters. Wow, we have a dollar already. I'm getting really sleepy doing this already, and I'm not even joking. One penny. This is a dime. A dime has Franklin Delano Roosevelt on it. Here is another dime. I have 20 cents. Oh look, it's a penny. Here is Abraham Lincoln. That is 22 cents. So far I have $1.22, 10 cents, $1.32, a penny. How much is a penny worth? Yes, a penny is 1 cent. It is 1/100th of a dollar. A quarter, we have now close to $1.50 because I lost count. Coins come in all kinds of different colors, and these ones are shinier than the other ones. Here is 3 cents. Because these ones are newer and have been taken care of more nicely. Let's count some more coins now. Here is a large plastic bag of coins. So we're going to count all of these coins, and next we will do an episode tutorial of Excel spreadsheets. Okay. And if you are interested in counting even more coins, I will have another episode which you maybe or in the future can click on through the description and can see me or my hands counting out coins and then putting them into wrappers so I can take them to the bank and deposit them into my account. Okay, I will be counting coins in my hand. 10 cents, 20 cents. It's good to split the coins into groups. I have 4 quarters, which I am going to put next to the dimes. 1 nickel, 2 nickel, 3 nickels. 3 nickels equals 15 cents. Good job. I have a bunch of pennies, but I'm just going to throw those away, because no one likes pennies. Here are all the pennies I have in my hand now. So calculate all of those coins, and if you are awake, please to comment on how much it's worth so that I can cash it in at the bank for dollars. Dollars are also part of money, and they are very relaxing. Here is a wallet, and we will now go through the dollars. Wow, I have lots of dollars. Dollars of all kinds. I can fan myself with them and can buy things at the store. Money is an excellent way to purchase things in most countries. And in some countries, you can even use US dollars in addition to the other country's currency. In the U.S., they accept U.S. money and occasionally Canadian quarters. Okay, let's count. $20. $20. So that's $40. $10, that's $50. That's enough to buy ten pounds of chicken. Here's a $5 bill, which can buy you half a lunch. So here we have $55. Now let's count the $1 bills. Everyone count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, look, there's a surprise one. I surprised you. There's a $6 bill, which puts all of my money in like the $70 range. So I'm doing pretty well for myself today. So let's do your own video to count dollar bills, and and to help people relax. Finally, I'm going to show you my very last video of the day, which is perhaps the boringest one of them all. So I'm saving this for last so that you are maybe already close to asleep, and then this will close the deal. The final video is, you guessed it, an Excel tutorial. So we're going to be watching an excellent Excel video called Growth Curve in Excel by Deanna Louyakis, who posts very nice tutorials on Vimeo. This one is a Creative Commons by Attribution license from 2012. So I can't guarantee the content of the video will be accurate, but that shouldn't deter you from watching it and letting it help you get to sleep. So let's look at all, we'll play the video now and look at all of the rows of numbers and in the columns, and we can see that there are different times and minutes and hours listed, and big numbers and small numbers. So if you okay, let's continue learning about all of the numbers. And oh wow, there are graphs in here too, where you can document all of your numbers into trends. So when you are counting your monies, you can enter the amount in Excel over time.
I know many of you had problems making your growth curves because you're not familiar with Microsoft Excel. This tutorial will show you the basics using Microsoft Excel 2011 for Mac. If I know the differences between Mac and Windows, I'll state them during the tutorial. For those of you using the older versions, I encourage you to take advantage of the free download of Microsoft Office through UF's website. You can also take advantage of free software tutorials through UF. So to do this, you go to software.ufl.edu, scroll down to where it says Microsoft Software for UF Students, click on eAcademy Online Portal. That'll take you where you need to go. You can download the software for free or pay an extra $15 at one of, I believe, four locations on campus, and you can have the hard disk. Also, for those tutorials, go to lynda.com through UF's website, and you can take tutorials on all kinds of software, including the Microsoft Office products, and we also have the Microsoft IT School or Microsoft IT Academy that you can go to. That all happens through the website. So go ahead and do that if you want some more practice with Excel. Okay, so here's the data that I posted to Sakai for your growth curves. First, let's go through the actual data, see what we have. So we start with BHI 37. So we all should know that BHI is brain, heart, and fusion media. This means that it's enriched with additional nutrients. So it's not just a carbon source, but it's also got other nutrients. So the bacteria don't have to make those in order to grow. And it's grown at 37 degrees. BHI 25, same at 25 degrees. BHI shaking, same, but with shaking. So consider when you analyze these, how shaking might affect the bacterial growth. Glucose min is just what it says. It's glucose minimal media. This means that there is a carbon source, the salts that the bacteria will need to grow, and water, but no additional amino acids or nutrients. So the bacteria will be making all the other stuff on its own. Chicken broth and the antimicrobials, that means that antimicrobials were added to that broth. So consider what effect that might have on the bacteria. Okay, so those are your media. Now, each treatment was done in 4 to 6 replicates. So first, let's calculate the mean. I do all my calculations right in the raw data. You can make a separate table if you'd like. Just click on the two columns to the right of where you'd like your new columns. Right click and hit insert. If you label the top of your mean column with the treatment name, Microsoft Excel will go ahead and make the legend for you. So that's how you'll do the first one. So first we'll do this first calculation. So you'll hit equals and then start typing average.
Okay, that's it for today's show because my phone keeps crashing because it has no more space. I hope you've had a very relaxing time and have learned a lot about numbers. So remember to subscribe and click on links and to like the videos and to follow me on Instagram and on other places. So have a good night, everyone. And I will see you again later for another episode of Falling Asleep with Mark. Bye.